Well, being an auctioneer sounds like an exciting job, but for decades the industry has been dominated by blokes. So to kick off our next round of odd jobs, we are meeting a female auctioneer who's bringing her hammer down on the industry. And Studio 10's Robbo spent the day on the road with auctioneer Kerri-Anne Davis.
Well, it's 10:15 on a Saturday morning in a suburb of Australia, and we are about to see an auction. Now, you can auction off anything from fish to speakers to paintings and, of course, a house, but you can't do any of that without an auctioneer. Now, the gavel is about to come down. Let's go and meet her. It's the ladies who are in charge, and we've got the best one in the business. We've got Bree. Bree, good morning to you.
Good morning. How are you?
Oh, I'm excited because I've never been to an auction before, and that is your full-time job. What does it mean to be an auctioneer?
Thankfully, I've been to a few myself. So obviously, Saturday's game day. It's the best day of the week for me. So it's my job to actually get the property sold.
Now, what are you looking for when you look out at the buyers? Can you see when you think, I can smell money on you?
Absolutely. I've definitely noticed Louis Vuitton bags before and Gucci shoes. Yeah, that's what I look for because I know that they've definitely got some more money to spend.
I was trying to joke there, but you really can smell that, can't you?
Definitely. I have said that to an agent before. I'm like, go back and get more money. She has more money to spend.
Now, can we make a deal right now? If you sell one, I don't know, because we're mates now, we kind of divide whatever you make just between us.
Well, you might want to talk to the agent on that because they're the ones that get the commission on the sale. Sorry.
Thanks, Bree.
$3,010,000. It's going to be sold. Paul, are we happy? Selling. Sold. Congratulations, sir. Very well bought. I've got the brains, you've got the looks.
Banks make lots of money. Well, Bree, you just sold another property. How was that auction?
That's it. It was a great auction, actually. We had a crowd full of people. The bidding started. It started strong and it just kept going and luckily sold right past reserve. We didn't have to go back and forth and we sold it under the hammer.
Is that the best part of the job when it gets really exciting? Big crowds, people are bidding?
Absolutely. And I think it's even more exciting when it goes well above the owner's expectations. So it actually is making a difference in someone's life, which is one of the things I love about my job.
Do you ever lose your voice?
Sometimes. I think at the end of the day, I think I might struggle today. It's a busy day, so see how we go.
What's the best part of being an auctioneer?
As I said, I think just making a difference in someone's life, whether it's the vendor actually exceeding their expectations and getting them a crazy amount of money over reserve or putting a family potentially in their dream home, I think, you know, that's the best part of my job.
Someone wanted to be an auctioneer, what advice would you give them?
Look, I think I would say definitely get out there and do as many charity auctions as you can to start. That's how I started. I entered a novice auctioneering competition and then just practice. Go and see as many auctions as you can because the thing is no two auctions are the same. It's always going to be different. So you have to see how different auctioneers handle different strategies.
All right, Bree, a big part of an auctioneer's life is obviously a big voice and one of these. How do I do it? I need some tips.
Okay, so be confident. Mm-hmm. Make sure you remember the numbers, I think is a good thing. And make sure you use the gavel well.
How do you use it?
You can use your hand.
Oh, right.
All right.
Okay, so.
Usually I use a contract, but you don't have one, so no. I'll let you use your hand. Do you want me to hold the microphone for you?
Sure, don't. Okay. Yeah, okay, ready? All right, so 30,000. Do we hear 30,000? The man up in the back there, 30,000, 35,000. We've got a woman, 35,000 sold. Ow!
Oh, yeah.
Is that all right?
I think you should keep your day job.
Okay, let's swap over.
Might have been all right in 1900s when properties were worth 30,000, but.
Oh, right.
Need a meal in front of that, yeah.
That's why numbers are important.
Yeah, absolutely.
I better not do this job again. Thank you, Bree.
You're welcome.